All man, and welcome to my UI and add-on video. Today, we will cover most of my add-ons I use and recommend to anyone looking for a clean and sleek UI experience, man. Anyhow, the add-ons covered in this video will be linked down in the description below, also with their respective timestamps, so be sure to look at that if you're lost at any point in the video. With that being said though, guys, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe down below, because you don't want to miss out on future videos. But let's just jump into it, man, and let's get it done, man. All right, guys, so the first add-on we'll be taking a look at is called Bagnon. As you can see right here, it is a bag add-on. What it is pretty much focused on doing is making you have one large bag, as you can see, instead of having all the individual bags, as you can see up here as well. It adds some search functions. It has a slew of different customization options. Sometimes it takes a little while to load, but yeah, it adds a lot. You'll also be able to see it in your add-ons right over here under your settings, under your interface settings. But yeah, pretty much we can close this, but you can change all kinds of stuff. You can take your bags away, you can change the size, scale, all kinds of things like that. So for instance, if you want to change the item scale, you know, the opacity of it, so if you want to have a slightly different, you know, size, or you know, like opacity to it, so you want to be able to see through it, it's pretty easy to do. You can change the color of it, you can do all kinds of other things. I don't want to change too much, but if you want to copy the settings I have, you want your bags to look like mine, there they are. But let's jump into the next one, guys, because we have a couple to cover. All right, so the second one we're going to be talking about is Mogget. Mogget is extremely useful because what it does is allows you to hover over items to be able to see what they would look like on you. For instance, like you can see any item that I hover over, it will show you what it looks like in its base ability, or you know, base form without a without a transmog on it, because it will not show that. Just always keep that in mind. But it's really useful for transmog if you have something drop that might be worth some money. You could take a really quick peek at it by just hovering over it like that, or just seeing what it looks like on your character, or maybe on something else, just in case you want to keep it. But yeah, if you're looking for something like that, I'd highly recommend downloading this one. And let's move on to the next one, guys. All right, guys, so the third one we'll be taking a look at is an add-on called Quartz. The only way I'm going to be able to show you what it looks like is when I actually go to summon my mount, or you know, hearth. But pretty much what it will do is it'll change the way the bar looks. You can change the tooltips, so you can see everything that you're possibly able to change by going right to your interface, go under Quartz right here. So you can change, you can set profiles based on your characters, specifically to your player itself, your target, focus, pets. You know, you could show trade skills on there, global cooldowns, the way they look, like the way they pop up, a bunch of other things. Pretty much you can customize it endlessly, change the color of it, the shape of it, do all kinds of stuff to it. Like for instance, you know, different bars can show up differently. It will show you your latency at the end, as I was showing right there. But it's extremely useful, especially for a caster. As a rogue, I don't really use it too much, but when I do play my warlock, I do enjoy having this one. But let's jump into the really good ones, guys, because the next couple ones are really for immersion. So let's just jump into it. All right, so now on to immersion. This one in particular is one of my favorites, but what this add-on really does is alters your user interface and or questing experience by altering the way it looks with a more modernized design. As you can see right here, it changes this. Also, when you pick up quests, when you get rewards, you can bring this menu up and actually show the items and what your rewards will be by holding down shift while in this menu. It's extremely useful. It'll actually add these like little talking portraits. So like for instance, if we go over here as well, you'll see exactly what I mean. It'll pop it up again like that, and it shows like all displayed down here, and you click through, it shows you how many parts. You can quickly click through that and pick up your quest. But it really changes it. It makes it look a little more sleek. I really, really like, especially this little thing right here that you can see, that in particular is really awesome while holding down shift. So don't forget about that little feature, but I highly recommend immersion. But let's move into the next one, which is Tidy Plates, which helps with targeting and stuff like that. All right, so here we are with Tidy Plates. Pretty much what it does is it changes the little name bar above characters and or NPCs. So when you go to actually fight them, you'll see like your bleeds pop up above, everything pops up above. It already does that in the base game, but it actually puts like little timers on it if you want to select it. It shows that I have aggro to it, shows your combo points. I think it just makes it look a lot cleaner. I really like the way it looks personally. It's really nice, and I highly recommend it. See, as you can see, it makes everything really super, super clean. So if you'd be interested in this one's called Tidy Plates. You can alter this one in many different ways as well. I pretty much have the default, but I really like it overall, and I highly recommend you should check it out. All right, guys, this is the biggest one, the one I recommend the most. I've just kind of started using this about a month ago. It's called SUI. You can get it to all the settings right in the menu right here. You can change everything. So, you know, you can pop on the little eagles on each side or the griffins. You do have to reload it, but you could pop on coordinates. You could do all kinds of stuff. It also changes the text. It also puts like little bars around stuff, as you can see, like little black bars around stuff. It kind of darkens your entire UI, as you can see up here around that. Also, I have to bring up my character sheet. It just darkens everything. It makes it look a lot cleaner. It also makes this possible to just disappear. I just really like how it darkens everything, kind of gets rid of some of that. But also, what I really like is it, as you can see, it changes the actual combat text in-game, the text over top of the characters, your in-game text over here. There is one little small note. It does make your chat pop up above like that instead, so when you type, it pops up like that. But honestly, I really, really like this add-on, guys. You can customize it in many different ways, as you can see right here again. Also, as a little added bonus, I do have details here. This mod allows you to see all kinds of things like spells. It allows you to look at healing meters, damage meters, resource meters to be able to see if people are interrupting properly or not in your raid group, depending on if you're into that kind of thing or not, or if you're a raid leader, just to be able to see what the problem is. But I highly recommend both SUI, all of these in this for your best immersion experience. But seriously, guys, if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to check out my other videos. I have plenty of other ones listed down below, but I really enjoy making this kind of stuff, and let me know in the comments if I can make anything more improved. But seriously, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Oh man.